SBS has broken news, questioned world leaders, changed Australia's cultural landscape. But this is our greatest single achievement.
We're picking the entrant for Eurovision!
Since the news was announced, SBS has flown into management mode. This will be no easy feat.
Don't worry, Mr. President, we've got it completely under control.
Eurovision is pop primetime, a career catapult, the mark of a people. And you, the people of Australia, have spoken.
They want Liu Lin Chin. Let's do this. Wait, where are we going?
I don't know, I was following you.
Liu Lin, Australia wants you for Eurovision.
I'm not sure I like the look of you at all.
My face cost us Eurovision.
It most certainly has.
With Liu Lin out, we assembled a crack team of the best pop music professionals SBS had to offer.
Nice one, we're gonna do this. This is great, okay. Great, nice work, Annie. Okay, guys, this is gonna be amazing. We've got a pretty hard job ahead of us, but I think that we can do it. All right, let's get it done. All right, does anybody have more ideas? Not K-pop.
What about the winner of Bollywood Star?
Okay, does anybody that works here listen to Australian music? Anybody? Yeah?
30 on for the grunt.
SBS's excessive knowledge of world music proved a hindrance. So with options all but exhausted, there was only one person left who knew how this would play out. The managing director.
We need to talk.
How'd you get past security?
Oh, there was no one out there.
Damn those budget cuts.
Eurovision, who is it?
I think I'm gonna tell you. Stop dreaming and get back to work. Go do something, get back to work. Who hires these clowns, really?
It was only when we studied last year's winner that we realised how hard this was gonna be.
Where are we gonna find a girl with a beard?
And we are now joined by noted Eurovision fan who may already have peed her pants, Jeanette Francis.
I didn't want everybody to know that. It is true. I have peed my pants from excitement.
And the reigning queen, hopefully continent queen of Eurovision, Julia Zemiro. Welcome.
I'm the most continent I've been in a while. Thank you. Welcome.
I don't even want to pass logic from that one.
No.
Now, I know that you cannot reveal who Australia is sending.
Well, of course I can. It's me.
Oh.
Yeah,
oh,
I will be singing for our country.
Figured as much. You are an Australian icon after all.
And I can do it. You know, I mean, I could just...
No doubt.
...get it under... No, it's not me, obviously.
Ah,
no.
See, that's disappointing. See, all today, we've been getting people to tweet in on the hashtag TheFeedSBS who they think should go.
Yes.
And whilst I know you cannot reveal, could you give us like a game of hot and cold?
I'd love it.
Humphrey B. Bear.
Oh, gosh. Hot. No, cold. Won't be Humphrey. It will not be a stuffed animal like Ireland did with Dustin the Turkey, correct?
So it won't be Bob Hawke then, by the sound
of
it?
No, it won't be Bob Hawke. Someone who can sing. Someone who can sing.
Okay, so exactly how are we going to go about picking somebody to send?
Okay, so a fabulous song called Euphoria won in Azerbaijan. The singer,
I remember.
Yes, the singer was Loren. She's Swedish, half Moroccan. And I interviewed the songwriter the following year. And he said, we had this amazing song, we thought. And we had five different singers come in, male and female, trying it out. And nothing worked, nothing clicked. And then Loren walked in. So she had done X Factor years ago. She wasn't the most popular person. She wasn't completely unknown. But something happened. Now, you can decide to take a chance on a slightly unknown person who's done a little bit of something and that great song, and it just rises to the surface. Or you can get someone like Bonnie Tyler. Now, I love Bonnie Tyler. Look at him laugh.
I'm
like
not laughing.
Under 40. You know, those of us over 40, we're very fond of Bonnie Tyler, but I thought she'd knock it out of the park. Didn't. Chose her own song, wrote it herself. Now, if someone had given her a song that maybe, you know, was a bit more Total Eclipse of the Heart, who knows, she might have got through. So it's actually a combination. The other thing is, too, it's a risk. Doing Eurovision.
Right.
You know, not everybody has the guts to do it, not everybody has the wherewithal to do it, and the energy levels to do it. It is an extremely tiring competition. They rehearse you within an inch of your life. And you need to be free. But we're just enjoying being part of it. We can't believe they're giving us a go. So,
yeah, I can't believe they're giving us a go. Why are they giving us a go?
Because they can't quite believe that we're so into it. I think in the last few years we've proven that we're big fans.
Yeah.
Sweden came to us when it was on in Sweden and said, we know you love it. Can you make a little 2-minute film and tell us why? And we did a cute little thing. Then Denmark said, well, actually, could you send one of your singers over to sing an interval? We've gone, yes. And they picked Jess Mauboy, who was magnificent. Is it a logical step that now they ask us to be part of it? Is it a coincidence that it's the 60th birthday? So there's a point, you know, there's kind of like, if we're going to give a wild card, let's give it to the people who've put the most resources, the most energy into making Eurovision what it is over that weekend.
So why is it, do you think, that Australians love Eurovision so much? Because we do have those big singing contests like X Factor and whatnot. What is that's unique about Eurovision?
Who doesn't love it?
That's right. I would challenge people on that exact thing. Well, we do have a couple of Europeans in the country. Now, let's just talk, if we win it and we do get to do it, gee, I hope they give it to Sam and I think that would be my fantasy job done.
And how do you rate our odds of winning?
Look, I really don't know. Gee, it's a crazy contest. People do the wackiest things. Look, the right singer won last year, Conchita, the beautiful drag queen. She absolutely hit the right mark. It was the zeitgeist. It happened. A lot of love in the room. It was fantastic. If we have a great song and a great performer, it'll cut through. The person who does it, there'll be a lot of pressure on them. A lot of pressure. So we'll be there with our flags, supporting.
Hopefully we will have the right singer, the right song and the right beards as well. Yeah. Julia, Samira, Jennifer, thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you.
All right, still to come here on the feed.